Kind of a weird title for a video, I know, but hopefully I can explain. A year ago, I made a video called Tony Stark, Our Brave Father. It's an 8-minute dedication to Iron Man and how quickly he became the father of the MCU after his first appearance in 2008. It focused on how Tony grew as a hero since his first appearance back in Iron Man, but more importantly, how Tony's brave journey through the MCU made him a father figure. He was a father to Harley Keener, a father to the Avengers, and he was Peter Parker's father. And that's exactly what I want to talk about in this video, the son of the MCU, Peter Parker. It became clear to me since Civil War and Homecoming that Uncle Ben was not going to play a big role in this franchise at all. Sure, his existence is hinted at and referenced a couple times, but if you're expecting to see Uncle Ben by Spider-Man 3, think again. And it's because Tony Stark is fulfilling many of the important Uncle Ben comic book roles in these movies. Peter learned that with great power comes great responsibility through Tony. Peter constantly blames himself for Uncle Ben's death in the comics because he just didn't care enough. And in Far From Home, Mysterio is the one that has the audacity to put the same burden of guilt on Peter, even though in this case, there was nothing Peter could have done.
If you were good enough, maybe Tony would still be alive.
Peter feels he has to live up to the pressure of becoming the next Iron Man. Let me just say this, the MCU Spider-Man has gotten plenty of criticism for Peter just being Iron Man Jr. Is this true? Well, yeah, kind of. And I don't really think that Homecoming or Far From Home are truly trying to convince us otherwise. They embrace it. Far From Home does try to show us that Spider-Man is his own hero that can stand on his own ground, but he still strongly resembles traits and characteristics of Tony throughout that journey. Because in this universe, Peter Parker does act as the son of Tony Stark. We've heard Tony reference that he feels like his dad when he's talking to Peter. Tony also refers to Peter as the kid. He feels a sense of responsibility to look after Peter, not just because he's his friend and mentor, but because he feels like a father figure to him.
You will not believe what's been going on. Do you remember when we were in space? And I got all dusty, and I must have passed out because I woke up and you were gone.
So you want to look out for the little guy, you want to do your part, make the world a better place, all that, right?
Yeah, just looking out for the little guy.
Captain, big fan of Spider-Man?
Yeah, we'll talk about it later. Just... Good job.
It's been 5 years. Come on, they need us. And then he started doing the yellow sparkly thing that he does all the time.
MCU Phase 1 starts with the origin of Iron Man, a man who built a suit in a cave with a bunch of scraps in order to ultimately achieve a bigger mission, to save half of humanity. And his shadow still lives and breathes in the MCU through Peter. I know some Spider-Man fans don't like this idea and take it as the MCU belittling the character. Oh look, Iron Man Jr. who relies on Tony to save the day. Oh look, Iron Man Jr. who relies on Tony to give him his technology. Oh look, Iron Man Jr. who weeps now that Tony's dead. Okay, I don't know if people actually said that last one, but Peter is 15, what, maybe 16 by now? He's a kid. Giving a hero like Spider-Man even a chunk of that ownership of living in his shadow in this universe actually makes Spider-Man quite special and important. Far From Home leaves us in a spot of Peter defining himself even further than that, though, of making his own legacy through Tony. I think we're gonna see an even bigger, stronger, and braver hero by the time we get to Spider-Man 3. But if you think Tony's tech is going to be tossed aside, or that Tony's legacy will be nowhere to be found in this film, then I think you're wrong, and I hope you're wrong. I like that Peter embodies Tony while still being himself, still being that friendly neighborhood Spider-Man who does things his own way. Just like Tony, Peter is brave. But he's always found the motivation to be brave within himself, not through Tony. He took down major weapons dealers in Homecoming despite the fact that Tony told him not to. He fought against Michael Keaton's Vulture after this conversation in the car. Yeah, I couldn't do it. He found strength within himself to lift the rubble after Tony took his suit and told him that he couldn't handle the responsibility as a 15-year-old kid. These actions could not feel any more like Spider-Man, and these are actions that he performed on his own. Just like Tony, Peter is funny and sarcastic, but in his own way. He's way more talkative and far less confident. Just like Tony, Peter is a genius, but in his own way. He can't design tech as well as Tony, but he comes up with brilliant ways to use it. Just like Tony, Peter is a leader, but not of the Avengers. He's his own leader, looking out for himself and his own community. What I'm saying is this. Peter is not Tony's replacement in the MCU, and I don't think he ever will be, but He is the son of the MCU, and he will continue Tony's legacy, but just in his own way. And that is an excellent and refreshing way to handle a character as special and important to me as Spider-Man.
I don't know if you've been in a fight before, but there's usually not this much talking.
All right, sorry, my bad.
Hey, Big Bird! You got me that rubber metal arm?
You guys okay? My bad, that was really hard.
Are you really friends with Peter Parker?
And I wanted you to be better.
I don't want to turn your head for one second
in the tables. If you were good enough, maybe Tony would still be alive.
The whole world is asking who's gonna be the next Iron Man. And I don't know if that's me happy. I'm not Iron Man.
And your friends are in trouble. You're all alone. The tech is missing. What are you gonna do about it?
You gotta fire up.